好像我的外婆啊，而且当年外婆的家似乎就是在南京路，离照相馆的地点不是很远。就是这张太像了，家里炸开了锅，一致说就是外婆，而背景的内容蕴含了她的名字与梅花相连，99%确认，谢谢。
Starting from today, we'll post some old photos taken in the 1920s by Sam Sanzetti, a Jewish photographer who worked on Nanking Road. The identities of the people in the photos remain a mystery. If you see anyone in the photos you might know, possibly your grandfather or grandmother, please contact us. Attached is a copy of Sanzetti's photo studio on Nanking Road.
That传说中的上海已经离今天太远了，像一面被打碎的镜子，难以重圆。这个消息很让人激动。
历史真是很奇妙。那时节，人们的灵魂还在。一个永久消失时代的墓啊，很美。以色列人要找，估计与当年照顾在沪上犹太人有关。大家帮忙转转吧。
慌安静，这就是老照片中的民国气质，太有气质了。如果是一个双面女间谍，跟一个长得酷似梁朝伟的特工，以现代标准看，这位民国女子从化妆到发饰，从表情到 pose， 都并不过时，经得起时间的考验。觉得那些旧旧的岁月，遥远的人们，简直美得令人窒息。
Shanghai was a bustling city, attracting both the good and bad. It was teeming with thieves, con artists, prostitutes, and slaves. Business was booming at every corner and pier. It was dirty, but prosperous.
We met 随着犹太摄影师沈师弟的一批肖像亮相于微博空间，那些优雅淡定的面孔，隔着时间的烟尘重新显影，一段上海往事渐渐浮出历史地表。我们将以此为线索拍摄一部微博互动纪录片，请你与我们一起踏上对照寻人的旅途。When
Sanzetti set up his studio on bustling Nanking Road, he probably had no idea that he would leave priceless memories for the people he photographed and generations to come. Before that Weibo post, I didn't know anything about Sam Sanzetti. However, he captured a beautiful time in old Shanghai, immortalizing it in his photos. When the camera was first introduced to China, it was thought to capture the soul of a person. It actually made sense. Those lively expressions in the photos truly express the soul of an era. In 1970, Sam Sanzetti conducted an interview with Yedioth Aronoff, an Israeli newspaper. It was his last before he died in 1986.
I was only 17 when I gave up everything I had and boarded a British ship. I got off when it stopped in Shanghai. There, I bought a really cheap camera. I was really interested in photography and took pictures of everything. One day, an American saw me taking pictures and invited me to work in his photo studio. It was in 1923.
In Judaism, wherever there's a synagogue, there's a home. My impression is the Ohel Moshe synagogue was a window to peer into Jewish life in Shanghai. On this site, the Shanghai Jewish Refugees Museum has been established. Among the Holocaust photos taken during World War II, the photos of babies being born in Shanghai became the most touching images. One photo was taken by Sam Sanzetti. He was apparently one of the most famous photographers in the Jewish community in Shanghai.
These men and women lived in Shanghai in the last century. Aren't they beautiful? Perhaps one of them was your grandparent. He took photos of government officials, aristocrats, diplomats, call girls, and film stars. This man was the French consul in Shanghai. This was a well-known chess master of the time. We'll post more old photos. If you happen to know some of them, please contact us. Thanks.
Within 15 minutes, a Weibo user recognized this general from the Chinese Navy. According to the information on the back of the photo, it was taken in 1923, the same year when Sam Sanzetti began to work at the photo studio. Dinosaur Hu Bo, an amateur military historian, was excited about this discovery.
就是我们现在想通过制服图片里面的一些细节，我们想知道制服图片的拍摄年代，准确的拍摄时间。您看从哪些方面能够看出？这张照片它主要是显示的它是在海军少将时期所摄，基本年代呢应该在1923年至1925年之间。那个时候呢就是陈绍宽是任那个海军总司令公署的参谋长。
那个总司令公署是住在那个南京的下关，他在1923年5月的时候呢，奉调到福建去担任应卫巡洋舰舰长的时候呢，升为少将，有可能就是他在从南京出发途经上海至那个福州的时候，在这里上海拍了这张照片。这里面我们看到的他这个衔别的标志是少将，
对，是少将，
一根宽的，一根中等的，因为位官还有一根细的。啊，位官还有一个细的。
对，
还有哪些元素能够？
确定，就是和时间相关的，和他拍照的时间相关的。时间相关，比如说他戴的那个勋章，他勋章呢可以看出这个得的都是那个，这枚是那个嘉禾章，这一枚呢是那个文虎章，这都是北洋政府时期授予的。然后他在国民政府时期呢也获得过勋章，这张照片上是没有的。
哦，
另外这张军服呢也是北洋政府时期的那个军服，因为国民政府时期的那个军服呢跟他有稍微一些细微的区别。 他嫁入国民革命军的时候呢，已经是中将了。
哦，已经中将了。
所以说不可能出现他佩戴少将时期的军服。
啊，
这个时期的照片呢，基本上是拍摄于1928年，之后他就升为那个上将的海军部部长了。
这个已经是民国。
这个已经是国民政府时期。
国民政府时期。
对，你可以看见他胸前佩戴的勋章，没有一枚是北洋政府时期的。
和那张不一样了，是吧？
对，他北洋时期获得的嘉禾章和文虎章这上面都没有佩戴。
The man in this photo was soon identified as General Chen Shaoquan. In 1923, Sam Sanzetti was only 20 years old. To have an opportunity to take photos for a Chinese rear admiral must have been a huge privilege. It was very likely he got this opportunity when he worked for the American businessman. A Westerner once said this about Shanghai in the 1920s. It was as crowded as Calcutta, as corrupt as Berlin, as proud as Paris, and as loud as New York. Sam Sanzetti came to Shanghai when he was 17 and began to work for an American businessman when he was 20. What did he do in between to earn a living? I hope Professor Pan Guang, a scholar on Jewish studies in Shanghai, can tell me more about Sam Sanzetti.
I was born in Shanghai, but I left for quite some time, so my feelings about Shanghai might be different from those who never left the city. In May 2007, I bought a new camera. Then I went to film something by the Suzhou River with a friend. We filmed the properties Adrian Sassoon built. Then some websites used my photos. I felt good about it. In 2008, I decided to take more photos there. Then it was all torn down. at the early history of photography in Shanghai. In the late 1920s, the French introduced photography to Shanghai. At that time, photo studios were highly profitable. Each photo cost $4 to $5. At that time, $5 was enough to cover the living expenses of a family for a month. A photo with a signature was a cherished gift back then. Today, we can still see Li Hongjiang's photos with his signature. Most of a photo studio's clientele were celebrities or stars. It was during this period Sanzetti built up his techniques and his wealth. In 1927, he started his own photo studio and became famous among the foreign community. As soon as his business opened, he took a photo of Sterling Fessenden, chairman of the Shanghai Municipal Council. The signs of those stores were impressive and mostly bilingual.
Chang was one of the most famous female writers of the 1920s. To celebrate her life and achievements, her fans regularly gather at Eileen Chang's cafe for their book club.
蒋孝良先生是蒋家的后代。 他是在复旦大学那个时候话剧团的主要成员，所以他等一下一定要请你朗诵《乡愁》。好，
这是我想起，60年以前，抗日战争胜利的时候，我的姑姑、阿姨、表姐、堂妹，全都回来了。这时候集会，就像诸位一样，气泡渗透着上海的海派的那种氛围。今天让我重温，谢谢大家。
所以是吧？谢谢谢谢蒋先生。
我是就是参加这个活动是第一次，但是我以前也来过这里，就是和朋友喝过咖啡，我印象也蛮深的。很高兴认识大家，我是写小说的。
张爱玲就是他们家族是李鸿章的家族，所以他们会一直留下那个照片。那他写的对照记也是他童年时期，然后他家里就是谁跟谁的一些故事。
披字型白绸里穿着有点傻头傻脑的。
我喜欢我4岁的时候怀疑一切的眼光。
张家浜显然还是上海滩初期开埠时结的一块沼泽地，后来填了土，散散落落造了几幢大洋房。
This is my first time participating in the Cheongsam Book Club meeting at Eileen Chang's cafe at the Chengde apartment. It is here where the memories of the 1920s seem to have awakened. Today, we've read Eileen Chang's Looking at the Old Photos, the last book she published. Its old photos, like Sam Sanzetti's old photos, were portraits of a generation of Shanghainese.
去年有看到过有那个有犹太人
来寻找那个
照相馆，犹太人的照相馆留下的。
Israel in China, intended to re-encounter those who appeared in Sam Sanzetti's old photos.
Arc of Shanghai, Sam Sanzetti's exhibition of old Shanghai portraits, opens at 171 East Nanjing Road, exactly where his photo studio was located.
When we came to the building, so many times I saw it in the picture.את הפרסמות הענקיות על התערוכה. דרך החלונות הגדולים הביטו אלינו צילומים מוגדלים של סנזטי. פשוט עמדתי לפני החלון ודמעות של שמחה והתרחשות זרקו מעיניי. כך עמדנו הרבה זמן מבחוץ. ולא מאמינים ממה שאנחנו רואים. כאילו אנחנו בחלום, שאם ניכנס בפנים אולי הכל ייעלם.
Moshe Dexlerm, Sam Sanzetti's stepson, studied photography with his stepfather before he was listed among the top 20 photographers of Israel. By chance, he discovered a series of old photos taken by Sanzetti many years ago in Shanghai. He spent countless hours organizing and repairing the photos and contacted the Israeli consulate in hopes of finding out who these people were.
We are so happy that we've found 4 people who appeared in the old photos.
לכל אחד הגשנו במתנה צלמים גדולים. לכולנו זה היה מעמד מאוד מרגש. שוחחתי עם אנשים שזה הכיר אותם, צלם אותם. כל כך הרבה שנים עברו. הצלמים הם צעירים, יפים. הרגשתי שכאילו דרכי הם נפגשים עם סנזטי.
So from the consulate point of view, we are very happy to bring back these photos to Shanghai, to the Shanghainese people.
I've lost her. Thank you.
לעולם התערוכה ועברנו ליד ליד מתמונה לתמונה. כל הזמן הזה לא עזבה אותי המחשבה מה היה מרגיש סטנזיטי אם היה רואה כל זה. כפי שאני מכיר אותו, היה איש מאוד אימפולסיבי. בטח היה מתחיל לשיר ולרקוד משמחה.
是我从我儿子那个从网上看的，所以我当时非常激动，我想去看，想去看，看了以后就是我那天去了，我一个人去的，我还没告诉我儿子我去了，去了我看了我真神，当时我就晕过去了，真受不了，太想见太想见的人，看着终于看着，哎呀，我心里觉得我觉得他有很多话，或者我有很多话都想说。但是就是说，真是千言万语怎么说呢？就是太那个这段时光的这个变迁，对我们家来说，对我个人来说，带来很太多太多的。
就是你平时可能不想这事儿，但是一看到这个照片，
想去很多，
就那么多往事就一下子都涌上来了。那这个照片里面的父亲是您当时就小时候记忆当中的父亲的样子吗？
那这个照片呢，我印象很深，因为他跟我因为照片嘛，太像。因为我平时我跟我父亲生活在一起嘛，晚年的父亲是跟我在一起的。
那张照片也是拍在他晚年
的。他五十岁以后，他基本上就是
中年生的你。
五十岁的时候，他在上海还是很有事业的时候。那个时候就是有人推那种从书资料里证明，就是有人推荐我父亲到大成商场去做董事长。
当时大成商场是在南通，
那时候已经在大成商场在南通是南通的，是末代状元张謇和我祖父他们创业的。
Da Sheng Fabrics was a milestone in the history of Chinese manufacturing. It was founded by Zhang Jian, who scored the highest in China's last imperial examination. Chen Baochu's father.Chen Weiyong was one of the company's four shareholders.
He was not a bad person. He was a bad person.
He was a bad person. He was a bad person.
When Chen Baochu was eight, his father Chen Weiyong died. Zhang Jian took him in as his own son. During World War II,Chen Baochu was elected chairman of the board of Dasha Fabrics. Chen Baochu had a house in Shanghai near the Jing'an Temple in the French Concession, the city's most iconic district. Not very far from his home,was one of Sam Sanzetti's photo studios on Maoming Road. Sam Sanzetti's business grew rapidly, expanding to four photo studios in different parts of Shanghai.
Lao 先生正堪称美髯公，不过阴影估计很大。
不是导演就是画家。
真有范儿。
那当时就是说，父亲，你当时印象他是怎么一个人呢？
就是父亲对我，应该说是比较宽的，对任何人都是非常严的。我们很多人看着都发抖。我大哥看着就发抖，我大哥已经四个孩子了，看着我父亲，就是只看他抖。我爸从来没有。对我在我身上说过一句重话，
太疼爱你的，
太疼了，我说我要念升方级，好的，念升方级就念升方级，
这是你自己选的，
我自己选的，很好，就念升方级，我说我想学外语，他说好的，先给你找一个外国人来教我外语，
就什么都依着你。
哎，都非常依着我。实际上我有父亲留给我很多东西的，比如讲，他是给我留了一栋房子。
在哪儿？
在新乐路。
新乐路。
新乐路，不是一栋房子，是一个公寓，一个公寓吧，单元一个单元吧，一个单元，里边就有很多古董。我父亲呢，就是如数家珍的要跟我说，这无线电是什么什么牌子的，这里有些什么酒，那个灯是以前宫廷里买的一个灯，像一条龙一样的宫灯。
他当时就是这些都是留给你，他就觉得以后能够让你这一辈子可以
哎，对。
In the 1950s, Chen Baochu passed away. At that time, Chen Jingxi was working very hard to become a singer. His talents can be heard in the famous Chinese film, Gorillas on the Railway. He's retired now, but still teaches choral music. Almost every week, he'd go and help a choir at the Jing'an Community Center in Shanghai.
我们家就是这件，就好多在楼上试了，就这样。
最顶了，老早的最顶了。
对。当初辰光，我去的辰光，印象是相当好。我来的辰光是相当好。我从杭州过来，没看见这个，手头搿里，样相漂亮了，我说老清爽。两套卫生。
两套卫生。哎。大卫生，小卫生。哎。大卫生，小卫生。
小卫生，我是讲一张这一张毛巾嘛。
毛巾，哎，对。
那个大卫生。
大卫生。
像阿拉。困个房间，我阿拉跟我爸爸两家头困的，就是可能有做卫生的旁边头，卫生旁边头。
应该是没壁炉啊，应该是用烧搿个炮仗炉子，有的暖气还是
没个，没个，
没功能的。
搿幢房子后头洗手间。
公寓也好，洋房也好，交关侪有洗手间。
对，是
的。侪分得老清爽，洗手间还有佣人的灯笼，
对，
啥侪分得老清爽。
我到五三路叫海根，很漂亮的地方。
你当时跟父亲住在一起多少时间呢？
我四七年。四七年到了杭州。
到杭州。那时候就是跟他。
到牡丹江去了。到杭州住了一会儿，就到牡丹江去了。
那当时就是住，你们住的话是住在哪里呢？
住在莫干山，我们就是到塔山顶上必经处那个也造了一个别墅。我们在莫干山的时候呢，就说我们全靠周大哥了，我们生活全靠他。他呢一个人从山下
跑到山下去买菜，买完菜就上来，然后是吧？这是很辛苦的。现在越来越回想我们那个女的，确实没生活是颠倒了不得了，这样没人了。
我结婚是二十岁结婚啊，跟那个好久了，侬爸爸都知了。哦、嗯，我在听说啊，
这是没看到这边。
老早一讲那阿娘是啊，
嗯，
那爷个娘，
嗯，
阿娘呢，怕伊外头出去。给了，就叫伊吃，伊也不吃，
啊，
嗯，
不分，
哎，
是吧？
咱们岁老伊就叫伊吃大，伊又不吃，
哎，搿倒是好，
哎呀，搿点是蛮了不起，地球出去看伊，
出去看伊，对，那要不就平常就吃饭老简单，
吃饭老简单，
老简单，
简单的不得了，
是吧？我记得也是老简单，
我晓得呀，
一只牛肉饼好像，
哎，一张个牛肉饼，
吃了我牛肉饼。
怎么到冬天嘛是就是讲野鸡啊？
野鸡，对对对，野鸡。
野鸡屎，野鸡屎呢，拿生姜丝、姜瓜丝炒一炒，
嗯，
一吃开么子。
嗯
嗯。哎，一吃个么子啥，习惯了伊。
哎。
到杭州去对了。
哎。
到杭州去搿个。
楼下头，我记得。
哎，楼下头对伐？吃西红。
哎，西红。
西红。吃烧伊的。那个厨房里向搞，侬跟你是不是黄啊啥啊？伊讲，我叫人看好这种烧，直接叫我吃好了，我去个也，回来也吃好了。
那搿张照片我老怪了，搿张照片。
搿张照片不容易的，搿张照片真不容易。
对，
那清楚啊。
那清楚吧，搿张。
搿张照片哪能把侬留下来
个
嘞？
不是我留下来，就是一个以色列人啊，开了个照相馆，搞犹太人了，犹太人嘛，就是后生死脱了。其实是有一个儿子，就翻着这个底片，
对对，
到上海来寻着这个人，老照片人有吧？这个照片呢就公布了网浪上。
哦。
我是阿儿子个女朋友告诉我，看到搿天我看好几
天。哪个照片不容易留了？
是，我到南通去蒙古也没寻着呀。
哎。
谁这个叫蒙别人，别人侪蒙勿着。所以讲有一张照片，而且老激动啊，真老激动。我搿天看好之后，第二天。啥毛病了？房穿，房穿晓得吧？
房穿啊，房穿晓得。
有房穿了。
啊。
哦、哎呦，结果我抢救。
哦，搿结果呢？
对，结果医生讲侬勿好，讲我勿好听。
讲
话
老
实
了，
自了
不得了。
是不是讲？
不要
怕，
我们那个好，我欢喜那个。
哦，那个
我
怕
有
人怕
有
人
怕
的，不要
怕，
不要怕。
你
想
想
看啊，本来哪能布置法子啊？搿灯是阳台对勿啦？搿是阳台伐？哎，搿肯定是阳台。我老好记得
搿灯是
宫灯。啊？宫灯。
宫灯。
从木桂山回来了以后嘛，
哎，
搿么就讲房子，阿拉姐姐就讲搿房子。嗯，要给我告拨侬，告拨八百了，
啊，
对吧？告拨们就讲喏，底下去这个像就是侬的，
啊，
搿么侬自家喏，我带侬看看，每个号头得来个一趟两趟，看看这个啥物事，这个啥物事，这个啥物事，床浪下面这满天星的这收音机，因为当时都挺好，
很好的。
翻出一张姥姥姥爷家的老照片，老妈说是上世纪30年代拍的，这是我们家最老的一张照片了，马上翻拍存档。
而拿着玩具还不肯好好拍照的小妹妹，又怎会知道从小体弱多病的她最终会成为一名医生，并且做了一名大龄产妇。
看了沈石替晋中那些奇丽优雅的民国女子，忍不住翻出了如今已90高龄的奶奶的老照片。成都平原温润的气候滋养下的蜀中美女，60年甲子风雨沧桑，却沉淀下那份从容自在，让人犹在晋中。
我失去父爱那么久，把对父亲的思念和尊敬转化成对那些老人的敬意和爱，我愿意为他们服务。尽管我的年龄其实和他们相差不多，
浅浅的海水，我在这方打入怎内？
光阴。